Welcome to our coverage of the vice presidential debate. Joining us from New York is Ellen Ratner. She's the White House correspondent and bureau chief for Talk Radio News Service and an analyst for Fox News Channel. Thank you for joining us, Ellen.
Thank you.
So we had a debate. We had such low expectations of Sarah Palin. I think all she had to do was put paragraphs together and she would come out with something. How do you think it went?
I think, you know, she did put paragraphs together. She also used a very colloquial sort of fun English, thinking, common, those kinds of words.
Doggone, she said.
The base would love it, but I'm not so sure the middle is that convinced. Sort of intelligent people that are not quite sure they like Obama, but they're not quite sure they like McCain. And that's what these debates are about. Yes, they're about getting your base out of the House, but they're also about trying to move that 15 to 20% of Americans that are right in the middle of all of this.
Well, Well, wouldn't you say for much of the debate, if someone really doesn't understand the policy issues and they're just listening to hear whether someone sounds like they're talking, know what they're talking about, rather than actually knowing anything about the issues, I thought on the whole she actually answered most of the questions in a way that sounded okay. Did you find that?
Well, okay, but I think that she actually clearly avoided some questions. And unless you were such a partisan that, you know, you think everything she says is wonderful, which there are people like my mother-in-law would think, she actually clearly did not answer questions. And I think most Americans are wise to that. Most people in the middle. Yes, there were no huge gaffes on the Biden side. No, she didn't come, you know, totally looking like a rabbit in the headlights like she did with some of the things that she answered or didn't answer on the Katie Couric interview. But she also clearly did not answer things, and I think most people are wise to it.
So give me some examples of what she didn't answer.
Well, I think that she did not answer some of the foreign policy questions. That was pretty clear. I don't even think she really answered the energy questions all that well. And she certainly didn't answer the question about what she would do differently if she were president than if McCain was. And she didn't answer the sort of final Achilles heel question, which is, where is your Achilles heel? She just glazed right over that and went to her standard speech, her stump speech.
Well, the biggest difference seems to be, comes down on foreign policy to one thing. McCain knows how to win a war. And I thought actually Biden answered this one pretty well, very specifically. In fact, I thought he may have even done better than Obama did, where he articulated is that they are against preemptive war and they're against regime change, which is the Bush doctrine, which she had answered, or had trouble knowing what the Bush doctrine was in
right.
An earlier interview. But does this matter when these undecided votes, like in CNN, they were showing us this thing of undecided Ohio voters.
Oh, this green and red lines, right.
And it didn't matter what anybody said. It went up when they spoke. It went down when they didn't speak. Is this going to make any difference?
This election is going to be... I don't think it's gonna swing any vote. I do think Biden might have helped swing a small percentage of the undecided, very small, maybe 1%, maybe 0.5%. Of course, we all know that 350 votes can swing an election. So no. But I do think that one of the things that we will this election is going to be because of the economy. And because of security, but mainly right now because of economy. I mean, when you have something like today, then almost 500,000 new job people out in the last week, I mean, the last month, sorry. I know, I guess it's last week, 500,000 people.
Lost jobs,
I mean,
yeah.
You've got to do something, and she can give all the platitudes she wants, but I think Biden's to those.
Now, I found the whole debate kind of surreal. We are being told we are looking into the abyss with the economy, a 1930-style depression, even with a bailout package, and many people are saying it's not even going to be effective, but even even with the bailout package. We're looking at an abyss. We may see one or two of the major auto manufacturers going bankrupt. We could be looking at double-digit unemployment.
Well, of course, they just got $26 billion out of the budget that nobody's even talking about.
This is the auto manufacturer. And nobody's talking about a $615 billion defense budget that was somewhat quietly passed Saturday night.
No, they're not, and they're not talking about the India free trade pact and the nuclear pact and all that kind of stuff. Nobody's talking about the things that either he wants to push through Congress that's getting attached to bills or that have been pushed, and it's just gone off the radar screen, as has been the investigation of state prosecutors, that the federal prosecutors. None of that is being talked about because people are so spooked out about the economy. And I thought actually Biden did a much better job of explaining what they would do with the economy than she did.
So in the final analysis, if one does a straight horse race political assessment of this, Obama has been going up in the polls. There's been a fall in McCain. The actual approval ratings for Palin have been kind of free falling. Will she at least this debate accomplish a further drop in Palin's ratings and in some way shore up McCain's?
I'm not sure we're going to see a drop in Palin's ratings, but I don't think they're going to go up because of this debate. And the issue is that he's not going to fall through the floor like some liberal Democrats were hoping because of Palin. But I don't see that his numbers go up. But hey, a lot of this is, kind of kabuki theater.
Well, I was about to say exactly that, kabuki theater. And I wonder if, given this moment of economic crisis, when they're talking about something, the real world's kind of asserting itself so much in the election campaign that for the last few days, nobody even cared about the election campaign. And I'm wondering if there isn't going to be more of a profound disillusionment with the whole process and the media. Do you think this is something we're seeing?
No, I think people are really enjoying the horse race here. And I think that they really are enjoying the campaign. And I think they're kind of into it. And now people are focused on that and the economy. And they really do want to find somebody who's going to help them out of this mess.
So if you look at the polls right now and most of the predictions, Obama's going to win this by a few points unless something really out of the ordinary happens. Is that your take?
Ben Franklin said a week is a long time in politics, and that was before the lovely internet, fax machines, telephones, televisions, or anything else. It's just, I'm not in the prediction business because something could happen that would turn that election out on a dime.
But it wasn't tonight.
Today was not that event.
That debate was not much of an event in my mind. Thank you very much for joining us, Alan. Let's do it again soon.
Thank you very much. You got it.
Bye-bye.